Hi guys, I'm Seema and today we'll study about time and work, a very interesting and scoring topic in quant section. I'll be making many more videos on the topics related to quant, reasoning and English for phase 1 of RBI and SEBI. If you like my video, then do subscribe to our channel and for regular updates, hit the bell icon. Before getting started with questions, let us revise some basic concepts. Firstly, efficiency multiplied by time gives us the total work done by an individual or group of people. And we know that efficiency is inversely proportional to time given or time taken to complete a work. If X can do a piece of work in n days, then 1 day's work of X is 1 by n. If efficiency is given in the form of ratio and it is 1 by 3, then the time taken by X and Y would be 3:1, which will be inverse of the given ratio. Moving forward to the questions. Question 1. The ratio of efficiencies of P, Q and R is 2:3:5. The total wages of P, Q and R working for 14, 24 and 20 days respectively are 6,000. Find the total wages of 3 when P works for 9 days, Q works for 14 days and R works for 8 days. Let the efficiencies of P, Q and R be 2x, 3x and 5x respectively. As per the question, P works for 14 days, Q works for 24 days and R works for 20 days and the total of their wages is 6,000. Putting the value of their efficiencies in the equation, we get 14 × 2x work done by P in 14 days, 24 × 3x which is work done by Q in 24 days and 20 × 5x which is work done by R in 20 days equals to 6,000. On further solving, we get the value of x which comes out to be 30. Now we have to find the daily wages of P, Q and R. When P works for 14 days, he gets 28x. On putting the value of x and after dividing it by 14, we get the wage per day for P, which is 60 rupees. And similarly, solving for Q and R as well. So the daily wage of P is 60 rupees, for Q it is 90 rupees and for R it is 150 rupees. Now as per the question, if P works for 9 days, Q works for 14 days and R works for 8 days, then the total wages would be 3000 rupees. Option A is the answer. Question 2. A typist can type 5 sheets in 7 minutes. Taking double the time than the first typist, the second typist types one more than 7 times the number of sheets typed by the first typist in 1 minute. The third typist types at the rate of 10 sheets in 42 minutes. Find the average of their speeds per minute. First of all, in such questions, read the question carefully and then find the speed per minute or per hour as per the demand of question for all the given components. Now, we'll start with the first typist. Let his speed be S1. As per the question, it is 5 by 7 per minute. For second typist, read the question carefully. He types one more than 7 times of what the first typist types in 1 minute in double the time, which is 14 minutes. So when we will divide it by 14, we'll get the speed of the typist per minute come out to be 6 by 14 per minute. Speed of the third typist would be 10 by 42, which is 5 by 21 per minute. Average of their speeds would be 514 plus 5 by 21. 42 comes out to be 29 by 63. So the answer is B, which is 29 by 63 sheets per minute. This is the average speed of three typists. So here in this question, while taking down this information, be careful. Question 3. The ratio of amount of work done by X minus 1 workers in X plus 1 days and X plus 1 workers in X plus 2 days is 5 by 6. Then the value of X is? Don't panic when you see these variables. Keep your calm and proceed further with the given information and use the suitable formula. Here we have work done by workers in certain days. Here we have work done by X minus 1 workers in X plus 1 days is to X plus 1 workers in X plus 2 days, 5:6. We can write it as X minus 1 plus 1 X plus 1 X plus 2. 2 equals to 5 by 6. Here we have done nothing but put the values of this number of workers in first scenario and days, number of days, and then number of workers in second scene and number of days taken. Here we get 5:6. And on further solving, here we have the value of x which comes out to be 16. In such questions, we just have to put the value of given data in a systematic format. Question 4. If there is a reduction in the number of workers in a factory in the ratio 5:11 and an increment in their wages in the rate 22:25, then the ratio by which the total wages of workers should be decreased is? For questions where two scenarios are given, in initial and later format, the easiest way forward is to make a table and put down the given information systematically. Here we have number of workers, wages, total wages, and decrement ratio. Number of workers, initially 15, as we have been given in the question that it has been reduced by 15:11 ratio. So before 15 and now 11. And their wages, it has been increased by 22:25. So now here we have to find the total wages in both the case, before and after. So for before, we'll do 15:22, which comes out to be 330. And here 11:25, which is 275. These are the total wages before and after. So we'll take their ratio, which comes out to be 6:5. And this is the ratio which has been asked about in the question, which is the decrement ratio. The total wages has been decreased by 6:5. Answer is A. Question 5. P, Q, R and S are 4 taps which can fill a tank in 36, 18, 12 and 6 hours respectively. If P is opened at 10 a.m., Q at 10:30, R at 11 a.m. and S at 11:30 a.m., at what time is the tank filled? In such questions, we first take the LCM of the given 36, 18, 12 and 6, which comes out to be 36. So let us assume the capacity of tank is 36 units. Now we have to find the work done by each tap per hour. P, Q, R and S. For P, it would be 36 by 36, which is 1 unit per hour. For Q, it would be 36 by 18, which is 2 units per hour. For R, it is 36 by 12, which is 3 units per hour. For S, it would be 36 by 6, which is 6 units per hour. Their efficiency comes out to be 1 unit per hour, 2 unit per hour, 3 units per hour, and 6 units per hour. As per the question, P is opened at 10 a.m. So, the work done by P from 10 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. would be 1 unit plus 0.5 unit, which is 1.5 units. Similarly, the work done by Q, which is opened at 10:30 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. would be 2 units. For R, which is opened at 11 a.m. to 11:30 a.m., it would be 1.5 units. So, total 5 unit work has been done till 11:30 a.m. before the tap S has been opened. The remaining work is 36 units minus 5 units, which is 31 units. And we know that together P, Q, R and S, they can do 12 units of work per hour. So the time taken to complete the remaining work would be 31 by 12, which is 2 hours 35 minutes. Hence, the total time taken to do all the 36 units would be time taken to complete those 5 units plus the remaining 31 units, which will be 1 hour 30 minutes plus 2 hour 35 minutes, which is 4 hours and 5 minutes. And as the first tap was opened at 10 a.m., we can say that the tank will be filled to its complete capacity. At 2 past 5 in the noon, the tank would be filled to its complete capacity. Hope you found this video beneficial for your preparation, and if you have any queries regarding any questions, do let me know in the comment section below. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe.